The Pacific has an immense size, and not a single living soul on this God-fearing earth knows all of its secrets. That's why mysteries are so thought-provoking and leave us fascinating. And this one will not be any different. I'm your host Raphael, and thanks for watching. This is the series where I tell you a story, its subsequent theories and explanations, and then I let you make up your mind. If you like the weird, the wonderful, the creepy and the mysterious, you might want to subscribe and click the little bell to receive notifications. Also, if you enjoy this vid, you can like and share. Now let's take a moment and study the disappearance of the crew of the MV Joyita. The MV Joyita was a ship made from wood and built in 1931. It initially served as a luxury yacht for a movie director who named it after his wife. In 1936, the ship was sold on and was eventually acquired by the US Navy for World War II, which led to some damage. In 1948, the ship was sold privately and was overhauled. Over the following years, the ship would undergo several ownership changes. Okay, so nobody really wanted it. On October the 3rd, 1955, Captain Thomas H. Dusty Miller embarked on a routine merchant passenger run. It started off Apia, the capital city of Samoa, heading to the Tokelau Islands, some 430 kilometers or 210 miles away. On board were 16 crew, 9 passengers and 4 tons of cargo. This included medical supplies, timber, 80 empty 45-gallon old drums and various foodstuffs. Well, hunger wasn't an issue then. At port, the engine and the clutch had failed but were adequately fixed. However, the captain opted to leave with only one engine working. Despite this, the boat was still seaworthy. On October 6, 1955, it was declared overdue since no distress signal was received. They were thought to have encountered some difficulties or slowed down due to the one engine. After 5 weeks, without a word, the Royal New Zealand Air Force launched an extensive search and rescue, but found no sign of the vessel, leaving with only one engine working. On November 10, 1955, the captain of the merchant vessel Tuvalu spotted the Joyita of the Fiji Islands, 966 kilometers or 600 miles off course, floating aimlessly with the crew and passengers missing. Except for the empty oil drums, the 4 tons of cargo still there. The ship's lifeboats were also gone, and despite onboard distress beacons, they were never found. It's getting scary. The ship was in poor condition, with the flying bridge destroyed, windows smashed and barnacle growth on the port side. It had obviously been listing rather heavily for some time. A large hole in the ship's superstructure had led to flooding of the lower deck, and an awning made of canvas had been hastily set up over the deckhouse behind the bridge. Once boarded, it got even stranger. A doctor's bag on the deck filled with bloody bandages, the ship's logbook and navigational equipment such as the sextant and chronometer were missing, as well as several firearms, were also gone. All the lights were on in the cabins as well as the navigational light. The electrical clocks stopped at 10:25, possibly due to the generators shutting down, and the radio on the ship was functional and set to international distress channel. It had a 2-mile range due to the faulty wiring, but it appeared that no signal was ever sent. Can it get even weirder? Well, the starboard engine was inexplicably covered with mattresses in a misguided effort to plug the leak, and there was heavy clogging of the bilge pumps, rendering them useless. Also, the auxiliary pump was rigged up in the engine room to fight the flood, but wasn't connected to any power source. They ran out of time. There are more questions than answers in this case. The reason for the leaking below deck was a corroded pipe in the engine cooling system, and the amount of water would have made the ship's single engine unable to gain enough speed to steer. The fuel tanks still had a fair amount of fuel, and the boat was abandoned, possibly as early as the second night of the voyage. Captain Miller had an elapsed license and was in direct defiance of the maritime law. Moreover, he was found negligent for having decided to leave harbor with only one engine working. Well, that's no surprise to me. On top of that, there weren't enough lifeboats on the ship to accommodate all the passengers, meaning that their only choice was to take to the water with vests. Why would anyone opt to leave the vessel like that? The hull was intact in spite of extensive leaking in the lower deck, and it was fitted with cork lining the holes for carrying refrigerated cargo, making her virtually unsinkable, and further buoyancy was provided by the cargo of empty fuel drums. It was unsinkable, like the Titanic. The latter is the biggest problem in the first theory that the crew decided to abandon ship due to the flooding of the engine room. The navigational equipment would have been taken and they left on the life rafts to an uncertain ending. However, an experienced captain like Miller would have realized the ship wouldn't sink and that the best solution would have been to drift and to await rescue. Don't tell me. It's all going to come down to aliens again. But what if Captain Miller had either died or become incapacitated during the voyage? This could explain the bloody bandages found. The others may have subsequently panicked and hastily evacuated, taking equipment and life rafts. This is actually the most widely accepted theory, according to my sources. At least it's a down-to-earth theory. Captain Miller was supposedly in severe debt at the time of the disappearance, leading some to believe that Miller opted to use the MV Joyita for insurance fraud, before utilizing his influential position as captain to lead an evacuation. Perhaps then the group got lost. However, given Miller's experience, that would have been unlikely, especially given the navigational equipment that would have been taken. Why do people always think the worst of others? Given the debt problems of Captain Miller, it is likely he would have been hell-bent on reaching the destination in order to be paid. So when the ship started to flood, could other crew members have demanded they turn back? An altercation leading to the bloody injury or death could have happened. The group then abandoned the ship with equipment, only to get lost. My last comment, again, could they have passed a fleet of Japanese fishing boats in some clandestine operation that didn't want to leave any witnesses? Or did the Soviets, with the Cold War in mind, have kidnapped the occupants of the MG Joyita? Also, modern pirates aiming to steal the cargo could have been responsible for the disappearance, having dumped the bodies in the ocean after raiding the ship and getting rid of life rafts. Murder, mayhem, and destruction. I think my work is done here. Or maybe not, because if all else fails, if you eliminate all the possible, whatever remains, however improbable, must be the truth. Were they abducted by aliens? We knew this one was coming, didn't we? Auckland academic David Wright claims he has solved this great marine mystery. According to him, there is evidence that the boat was taking water leaking from the corroded pipe in the engine's cooling systems for a long time before anyone noticed. Wright believes the firearms may have played a key role in forcing Miller off a wooden vessel he personally regarded as unsinkable. One by one, they would then have drowned or have been killed by sharks. Now that's very tragic. This is another strange and tragic one, a maritime mystery that probably will never be solved. However, everybody can have a shot at it, so you decide. There is a lot more to say about this topic than I did in this small vid, so if I forgot something or you have something to add, don't hesitate to do so. If you wish to do your own research, the links in the description below might be a good start. Your thoughts and opinions are much appreciated, so drop a line in the box below. Just be respectful in the comments, as there are real people with real feelings on the other side, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!